Good morning, I'm Patrick Lavery, and for Eric Scott, it is Monday, July 25th, 2022. Those with the resources fleeing to pools, beaches, and higher elevations during the weekend as a nearly week-long hot spell only intensified further. Newark on Sunday saw its fifth consecutive day of 100 degrees or higher, the longest such streak since records began in 1931. Chief Meteorologist Dan Zarrow has the latest at NJ1015.com. New Jersey is expected to have more than 3,000 drug overdose deaths by the end of this year because, as we have told you previously, dealers are lacing everything with the powerful synthetic opioid fentanyl. But a plan has now been unveiled that aims to change things in the state. A 79-year-old Bergen County woman killed in her own home over the weekend, authorities say by her own son and by his own admission. The Daily Voice reports that first responders found Linda Maupai struck in the head by a fire poker in Dumont, her 40-year-old son Patrick being the one who called 911, admitting the offense and being taken into custody. Four people killed early Saturday morning in Newark when their car goes underneath the trailer of an 18-wheeler. A fifth person was reported hospitalized and in critical condition after the crash. Two passenger vehicles and the tractor trailer all caught fire. The crash is under investigation. Officials at the Delaware Water Gap say a 14-year-old boy from Elizabeth has died, his body pulled from the river near a picnic area Sunday after he did not resurface from a swim, according to the New Jersey Herald, which further reports the teen was not wearing a life jacket. It is the second drowning at the recreation area this year. Remembrances are pouring in and flags have been lowered to half staff across the state in memory of Republican Assemblyman Ron Dancer, who died this weekend following a long illness at the age of 73. Dancer, an Army veteran turned horse trainer, then Plumstead mayor and state legislator, was heard many times discussing bills and proposals here on New Jersey 101.5. Some of the state's budget surplus was put into a fund to pay down debt or pay for construction without additional borrowing, and $814 million of that made it to NJ Transit, which will use it for work at seven stations, accelerating projects that were years down the drawing board. The House January 6th committee said Sunday it will interview more former cabinet secretaries and is prepared to subpoena conservative activist Ginny Thomas, the wife of Supreme Court Justice Clarence Thomas, as part of its investigation. Lawmakers say they are deepening their inquiry after a series of eight hearings in June and July. About two in three Americans say they favor term limits or a mandatory retirement age for Supreme Court justices, according to a new Associated Press poll. The poll conducted just weeks after the high court issued high-profile rulings, including stripping away women's constitutional protections for abortion and expanding gun rights. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen on Sunday saying the U.S. economy is slowing, but pointing to healthy hiring as proof it is not yet in recession. Yellen spoke on NBC's Meet the Press before a slew of economic reports are released this week, shedding light on an economy currently besieged by rampant inflation and threatened by higher interest rates. Also this morning, your job isn't as protected as you may believe. Like nearly every other state, New Jersey runs a system of at-will employment. We chatted with a local attorney to create a rundown of what this means for you, and Dino Flamia has that conversation today on air and online at NJ1015.com. More information may be emerging about the Amazon worker who died at the fulfillment center in Carteret during the online retailer's annual Prime Day this month. But it still may not be enough for co-workers, according to NBC, who have been frustrated about a lack of info divulged about their colleague Raphael, said to have experienced chest pains the night before his death. And Jersey gas prices continue to plummet, starting this final week of July at an average of $4.46 for a gallon of regular in the Garden State. Now, while that's way down from a month ago at $4.92 and from the high on June 13th of $5.06, it is still more than 10 cents higher than the national average. Cheapest in the state, up in Bergen and Passaic counties, $4.40 on average. That's the latest from the New Jersey 101.5 newsroom this morning. I'm Patrick Lavery. Eric Scott rejoins you tomorrow. Like and share this video throughout the day to keep the conversation going. Of course, tune to New Jersey 101.5 for all the latest news, traffic, weather, engaging talk throughout the day today. And go to NJ1015.com for breaking news. Make it a great Monday.